So I've realized something of late. I kind of missed out on doing something that I could have been doing all this time, and there's a cat trying to get in the way. I haven't really talked about controllers much, so I'm going to change that. So I'm going to do short reviews on controllers I have or any I get, which I need to get a six-button arcade controller for the Genesis Mega Drive. I would like to get Mortal Kombat again. Anyway, that's it. Go over there. So I'm going to talk about this. Now, first thing I will tell you is that this looks exactly the same as the ones in PAL territories in Japan, except for those say Mega Drive on it instead of Genesis, obviously. That, and they have different colors. For example, I know for a fact that in Japan the start button's blue. Can't remember about the rest. There's also two different ones of these in North America. This is one of them. I call it the black controller. The other one has red accents. The letters here are red, has red on the buttons themselves, and this white around the D-pad is actually red. Other than that, not much else different. So let's get into it. First off, D-pad. Very nice. I mean, not perfect. Nothing is perfect. I like the D-pad on the six-button arcade controller a little bit better, but, you know, I like this one a lot because I'm used to it. Works very good. It's very responsive. Easy to clean, too, which, by the way, overall, controller itself is very easy to take apart and clean. It's only got six Phillips screws. Very easy to take apart and replace if you have to. Just make sure you have one that goes down in there. Don't strip the screws either, because you'll have a harder time ever to remove it trying to take the controller apart again. Anyway, very nice placement of the buttons and the D-pad. In fact, one of the things I love about this controller is where the start button is. It's very easy to reach as you're playing, and you don't want to, like, say if you're doing OutRun, you don't want to get off the accelerator, but you want to pause it so you can go to the bathroom. It's very easy to get to it. So there's that. Now, one of the problems with this controller is that it's not good for fighting games at all. I can think of a few that only use three buttons, so it's good for that, but even then I recommend using the six-button arcade controller. Still, use the anything that's not this for a fighting game. Everything else, though, you're fine. There are a few games that actually do use or require a six-button controller, but they're few and far between, so there's that. Really, you don't have to use one of those unless you're doing one of those kind of games. But this is fine for everything else. I mean, just for example, Sonic 1, 2, and 3, all three of these do the exact same function, this button. Also, same goes for Sega CD. Now, one thing I don't hear anyone ever bring up or mention is, or ask, why does the B have that little bump, and why does it say trigger? It's the same in all the regions they say, except for I think Japan has a different word instead of trigger. So here's the explanation for this. I'll talk about the word trigger first. One, maybe you might have noticed this playing games. B is used as the main action button. If not all the time, if not most of the time. So that's why. Why they decided to call it trigger, though, that I can't tell you. I guess, you know, trigger, name thing. But I would have probably called it action or, you know, whatever. It's not necessary. So that's why they say that. That is the main action button for most games. Funny thing, though, is a lot of games actually use C to pause, yet there even is a start button where you start to access menu and shit like that. So it all depends. Now, the little bump on the B. That is not braille for, like, blind people or anything. I have heard someone say that once, that's why I'm bringing it up. No, that's not what it is. That is the same thing as you have on a keyboard, where F and J have a little, except for those, it's not an actual dot, it's more like a line. But it's basically finger placement. Yeah, I know, it sounds ridiculous, even though there's only three buttons, and you got a D-pad, and there's one start button up there, which is way smaller in a different shape. But that is what those things are. There actually is a name for it, but I can't remember it right now. You know, it's kind of like Chad, the little pieces of paper to hang off of something when you use a hole punch. Everything has a name. That's what this is. That's all it is. Finger placement. I actually have seen a controller where that's worn off, believe it or not. Must be some mad finger mashing going on in that controller. So really, that's all there is to talk about. I like this controller. The only thing left is the wire. While it's not the longest one, it is pretty long. There actually is an official controller extension you can get, or you can use the power plug as I mentioned in that video a long time ago to extend the controller. It's pretty long. One thing I do want to mention is that, as with the one with the red accents, the plug looks a little bit different. It doesn't have this ridge stuff. It's more flat, and it says SEGA on both sides. So there's that. This controller, you can even use it in an Atari 2600, and then a couple other things that are more obscure that use the same kind of connector. So there's that. This will work on a Model 1, a Model 2, the crappy Model 3, CDX, a JVCI, so on and so forth. I don't know if the laser active pack can use this, but yeah. So that's about it. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time. Adios.